going on, gentlemen? 1247 The Great One, man. It's a great day to be great. I hope you guys are doing well. Hope you gentlemen are doing well, man. Hey, gentlemen, check this out, man. I got something that's on my mind. It gets me mad every time I go to the so-called manosphere and I hear the so-called one particular gentleman talking about the so-called average guy. See, we're going back to the average guy conversation again. And a couple guys in the manosphere talking about, you know, when you go outside the so-called community, the women only desire the so-called high-value man, right? See, when you go outside the so-called community, these women only desire the high-value man and all this nonsense. Gentlemen, let me tell you something, brothers. Let me tell you something. The more and more I'm going through and finding out a lot of things. I've been in the bubble for a long time. And gentlemen, I got to say, there are a lot of groups of women that desire the so-called average man. You know, there's a lot of women outside the so-called American Black community that desire the average man. So, gentlemen, don't ever in life get it twisted and think that nobody desires you because you're making 40, 50, 60, 70, 80K and all that other stuff. Only the women outside the community only desire a high value man, six figures and all this nonsense. Gentlemen, this is one of the reasons why I'm starting to disconnect from the whole manosphere altogether. Because it just seems like there's an agenda. It's like it's always an agenda to tear the so-called average guy down. You guys ain't nothing, or you're dusty. Like I said, I mean, I'm not gonna say my man name, but the main guy in the manosphere, the top of the food chain guy, he's always talking about, oh, you average guys, you dusty, and this, that, and the third. But only, you know, Maria and Becky and all these other group women only desire the so-called high-value man in the so-called American Black community. And you average guys don't have a chance and this, that, and the third. Gentlemen, don't listen to none of that stuff. Don't listen to any of that stuff, gentlemen. Do not listen to any of that nonsense. There are plenty of women that's out here that want you because of you. Plenty of women. You ain't got to do this King Kong nonsense. Women desire you because of you. Like, so gentlemen, stop listening to a lot of this manosphere talk and it's you know, every time it's a manosphere, it's getting corny because now it's like everything is about going back to where you started. And you know, it was about, first, the manosphere was about building yourself up and men going their own way. I mean, brothers venting and things of that nature. But now it's like, okay, cool, gentlemen, you did all that venting and all that building yourself up. Now it's time to go back to the plantation. You know, all you average guys, man, it's time for you guys to go back to the community and rebuild the community. Like, I'm hearing more and more of that talk. Like I just heard listen to the Bernard Riley show. You know, oh yeah, well, I think that black businesses need to hire black men. Gentlemen, don't get caught up in that nonsense. I keep telling you, it's all about survival, gentlemen. It's all about survival. When you talk about the American Black community, the only thing they thinking about is survival. They don't want you so-called average, hard-working, blue-collar, whatever you are. They don't want you guys to go because you are the meat and the potatoes of the black community. Everybody knows this. You blue-collar, whatever, you bus driver, police officer, you the garbage guy, the guy that drives the bus, the brothers that do maintenance, the mechanics, all that stuff. I mean, you guys are the meat and the potatoes of the so-called American Black. You are the glue that's holding everything together. Everybody knows this. Then when you come over here to the manosphere, they act like, oh, you just a piece of boo-boo. They talk just like this, the women do. The women call you dusty, rusty, and the top dogs in the manosphere do the same thing. Oh, nobody likes you. Becky doesn't like you, and Zankwa doesn't like you, and Maria doesn't like you, and Lourdes from Ethiopia don't like you, and you guys are just, you know, nobody's really checking for you like that, and blah, 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 blah. Like, come on, man, too much. What is it? Too much, what is it? Dick policing. Penis policing. Too much penis policing going on in the manosphere. All this boogie woogie stuff. I don't get that, man. It's just silly. You gentlemen can't be who you want to be. You can't be who you want to be with. You gotta come back to Bone Sheikha. Come on, man. Gentlemen, like, rise up, man. Snap out the illusion. You already know, gentlemen, nothing's ever going to get built. Nothing's going to happen in the so-called American Black community. It's not happening. It's never going to happen. American Black community is the woman. And you already know, like I did two vlogs before, that these women are in survival mode. So don't come over here and be listening to these cats in the manosphere talking about something. Oh, well, gentlemen, I know you're trying to make moves, but you know, I think you guys need to go ahead and build back black families. Come on, man. It doesn't make sense. Brothers come here to vent. Now I'm looking at the Roger Report, or do the black men owe the black community, do we owe the black community anything? Like, what are these talking points? Gentlemen, when you come to the manosphere, it's a bunch of the men. You got men out here stalling. You have male agents for these females. Anything to try to get you back towards the plant, towards the freaking concentration camp. Anything to get you back. You can't be free. Because you belong to us. Like I keep telling you, gentlemen, these women really do think you belong to them. I tell the story all the time. Listen, Eve wasn't Adam's wife. Eve was Adam's freaking handler. She was his freaking the warden from the jail. Man, this woman's she's her handler, fellas. She's not your wife. These women don't want you. How many times you keep hearing it over and over again? These women talk. They rather steal your sperm, have babies, and reject you. And use them babies to get money out you. I mean, they put it right in your face, gentlemen. You can't even deny it anymore. But you come over to the manosphere, they talking about some, well, yeah, gentlemen, I hear all that, but you guys need to go ahead and build black families. Come on, man, gentlemen. You gentlemen, there is, I keep telling you, tell you guys all the time, there's a lot of people that's watching the mass majority of brothers in the American black community. There's a lot of people watching you from close up and from afar. There's a lot of people that got their eyes on us, gentlemen. You have to recognize that you are the spotlight is on you. You have options everywhere you go. I told you, gentlemen, listen, what do you see you singing church? Payday's coming after a while? Nah, gentlemen, payday's coming now. It's time to be back on top, gentlemen. And everybody's checking for you. Everybody's checking for you. So don't ever sit here and think that, oh, ain't nobody looking for you. Yeah, they are, gentlemen. There are a lot of people, a lot of women out here looking for you. A lot of women out here looking for you. I'm not gonna lie, cause I've been in the bubble. I didn't listen. Gentlemen, I'm going to. I've seen a couple of things on Instagram talk about some. I know there was. Listen, I'm super slow. Don't laugh at me, but I didn't know there was a such thing called like black breeding. There's something called black bread. Blacked. You know what I'm saying? This stuff like black owned and all, bro. These women, they desire you, gentlemen. They like, there's women out here right now. When you walk around, that's has desires for you gentlemen. It's real out here. You gentlemen got come, you gotta what's my man, Mad Buster, like he said, you gotta switch up you gotta switch up your lens a little bit. I know you gentlemen waiting on Big Booty Keisha to come back and submit. Gentlemen, she not coming. LaRonda's not coming. Takesha's not coming. Shaquana's not coming. They don't want you. But Bethany wants you. Maria wants you. Zhangqua from China, Korea, whatever, the Philippines. These women want you, gentlemen. You have to open up. You gotta open up your eyes a little bit. You gotta open up your eyes a little bit. You know, stop closing them and open them up. There are women that out here that desire you. Stop listening to your mama and them. Stop listening to your auntie and your cousins. Oh, nobody wants you because you're corny. Nah, gentlemen, listen. Nobody wants a freaking King Kong. You don't have to be anybody's King Kong and be running up on people and butting and shooting people and doing that caveman nonsense to prove that you're a man. Come on, gentlemen. Use your brain. Yeah, I got to defend my territory. You don't need to do all that. That's archaic. Use your brain, gentlemen. There's a lot of women out here that desire you. One thing the manosphere don't really promote is traveling. Then these brothers don't want you to travel. Like, damn, like, what are we? Okay, cool. So we can't talk to the women outside of, we can't really, it's like 50, it's like, I can't say 50, it's like 70, 30. Like, yeah, you can, but it's like, nah, they really don't. But then you want to travel, then they clown because now, oh man, you guys out here traveling. Like, what the, gentlemen, like, what are your options according to the manosphere? If you listen to the manosphere, what viable options do you have according to these guys over here? What are your options right now? Because if you can't really travel, they clown you for kind of traveling. Oh, you got to travel for some vagina. Okay, cool. So I really can't travel like that according to y'all. But then So I go outside the so-called American Black community. You know, yeah, you can, but you know, you guys should be building Black families. So, gentlemen, what can you do? What can you do, gentlemen? What are your options right now? I know my voice going high. What are your options right now? If you can't really go travel like that because you're getting clowned by the manosphere, but then, okay, in your own city, you know, if you want to even, you know, you want to try Becky, cool, knock yourself out. If you want to try Maria, you want to try the little Asian girl, the little Ethiopian female, because you know that Ethiopians, that's my thing. That's just me. The Dominican sister, you know, can you talk to any of these women? But according to the manosphere, you can't get them like that. You can't get them because you're corny. You're corny. And you don't make enough money. This, that, and the third. So, gentlemen, what are your options according to the manosphere? What are your options? If you listen to the manosphere, who are you going to go back to? Who are you going to talk to, gentlemen? Yeah, you can talk to Becky, but you really shouldn't. Okay. Yeah, I know Maria. I know she's feeling you, but you know, she don't got flavor like that and blah, blah, blah. I mean, all types of stuff that the manosphere throws at you, gentlemen. I mean, who are you supposed to talk to according to the manosphere? They do all this talking about what Keisha doing and Keisha out here and all this and weave and blah, 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 obesity. But at the end of the day, I'm supposed to go back to the so-called Black community. I came here to vent about the Black community. Yeah, brother, I hear you're venting, blah, 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 but you should go back and build Black families. Come on, gentlemen. Like I said, the manosphere is a joke. It's a joke. It's a joke. And I mean, it's been here for a minute, but I'm just gonna be honest with you. I think the so-called SYSBM is probably gonna take the place of the Manosphere. That's what, to me, if you ask me honestly, SYSBM should be the Manosphere. Because you got brothers trying to save themselves for real. Like, listen, we're not trying to rebuild anything. We're trying to transition and we're trying to do other things besides sticking around and building something that's really burnt down. So I believe SYSBM is going to take the place of the Manosphere. I don't know how much longer the Manosphere is going to be here, because, I mean, truthfully, they probably got a couple more reports, and I think the so-called Black Manosphere is about to be done. But SYSBM is going to be here for quite some time. It's probably going to be the standard of brothers. Hell, it might be the standard of quite a few men, other groups of men. Save yourself. Explore your options, gentlemen. Explore them. You have women. You have a lot. Listen, brothers. You have a lot of women that desire you. Even myself, I'm not out here trying to. You know, I'm trying to build. You know, I got my little. Listen, I got my clothing brand. I'm trying to get cranked up. I got my kids. They doing their thing and they're acting. I got my motivational thing. I've been building on this comic book thing for the last year, and I got a couple other things that I'm doing. So, I mean, I'm not in nobody's club. I'm not in nobody's bar. I got too much things to do to be sitting here and just be in Becky's face all day. I just don't have that type of time. And I'm trying to switch it up, but I mean, my mindset right now is just to build. It's just to separate myself from all this mediocrity that's around me and just go somewhere and just build. That's my mindset right now. So I could get out there to, you know, I could go to some bar and get it cranked up. But to me right now in my life, I just don't have time to be sitting here playing games and taking females out to eat. And like, I have too much I gotta do. Too much that needs to be done. And that's where my mindset is. Maybe your mindset's just like me. It's just you trying to build and things of that nature. You know, your mindset's not really on the females right now. And that's a good thing. That's fine. My bad. Mosquito. That's a good thing, gentlemen. You know, I do believe in the so-called universe, whatever, the creator, this and the third. So, I mean, whatever woman that you want, I mean, I'm pretty sure if you've been through the nonsense like me and going through what I've been through the last decade with my ex, like, yo, I need somebody that's going to do what's to be Destiny's Child. So I want somebody to cater to me, daggone it. I need somebody to cater to me every once in a while. And my eldest brother, you know, my eldest brother, you know, 7 years older than me, he's married. He was married to his ex-wife was white, a white girl, and his new wife now is another white girl. And what he told me when we were both in Japan together, almost like 20 years ago, was, you know, hey, bro, taste the color of the rainbow. He said before you deal with these sisters, you need to taste the color of the rainbow before you settle down with one. And I did, and when I was in Japan, I had a taste of, you know, the Japanese girls, but I mixed it up a little bit, but now I'm just like, I'm just trying to see the best options. Here's where I'm at now. I'm trying to see what other women are talking about. You know, I know women are women. Don't get me wrong. Women are women. So I'm not putting any type of female on some type of pedestal. I know women are women, and basically they want security. They want provision, protection. Gotcha. I just want to see what type of package. Okay, I'm trying to see what real femininity looks like. Because, I mean, let's be honest, in the so-called American Black community, these sisters don't. A lot of these women are just so masculine. They don't. I mean, if somebody has to teach you how to be feminine, gentlemen, it's just not in them to be feminine. Let's just be honest. If somebody has to teach a grown woman how to be feminine, gentlemen, it's just not in her nature to be feminine. So in my life right now, I'm trying to see what femininity really looks like a female that's like with your program. Like if I say let's move, she's gonna move with me. Like I'm trying to see that. I haven't seen it yet, and that's what I desire in a female, like a true feminine woman, one who's gonna nurture, one who's going to, of course, submit, one who's going to be with my program, a woman who's truly going to support, a woman who's really going to uplift. Once again, I don't need my mama, but I need somebody that's going to be in the trenches with me, like somebody that's going to be like, yo, babe, you know, boom, let's make this happen. Like, I see your vision, I see what you're talking about. Boom, I can give her the plan. And wow, she's off and running. She's off and, you know, she got her wheels turning. She's gonna take, you know, her education, her expertise, and you know, we can build on what my vision is. You know, she can bring her expertise and bring it over to what we're doing, and we can build something nice. So that's what I'm looking for moving forward. You know, don't get me wrong. It's nothing wrong going out to eat this and the third, but I'm set right now on like really building. Like I got to create platforms. I got to. And that's what you gentlemen need to do. You got to just, your mindset is on build. You should be building. And the female that you need should be, hell, she need to be a builder with you. She might not do physical, but hell, if she got some type of engineering degree or something, she can help you marketing, whatever, to get your brand or whatever you're trying to do. That's what you gentlemen should be looking for. You know, if I can give her the blueprint of what I'm trying to do, can she take that and build upon it? Or if you just give it to her. You know, like a lot of these women in the so-called marriage. Nah, I'm not going to point the finger. But, I mean, a lot of these sisters just about them. I want to say it like that. But, yeah, a lot of these sisters up on their own time. But I want a female, if I give you something, can you take that and can you expound upon it? Can you add to it? Hey, babe, you said this. Okay, I checked into it. And, you know, that it's feasible. And boom, boom, boom. Okay, these are the numbers and blah, 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 blah. Yeah, we can do that. We can move forward on that. See, that's what type of female that I need right now. Boom, I got, hey, this just came up. Hey, what, you know, as I'm going through, you know, I got different ideas coming to my head. You know, if I spit it to her, you know, can she build on that? Can she take my idea and bring it to the next level? Or can she add a point? Can she multiply my idea? Can she add to it? Because I don't need a female that's going to subtract and divide no more. I can't have a female that's going to subtract. I give you an idea. Maybe I'm putting money away towards this. And you go right into what I'm doing. You pull from it because, oh, I just had to get my hair done. All this dumb stuff. Like, I don't need a female that's going to subtract and divide. I need a female that's going to, I need a female that's going to multiply. I need a female that's going to multiply. I don't need subtraction and division. I need multiplication. I would say add, but no, I need multiplication. I need a female that's going to multiply what I'm trying to do. And you gentlemen should be looking for that too. You know, we got to get away from the physical. I understand she got pretty face and big titties, a big butt. I get it. We all want that. You want that attractive. You want the super freak. We all want that. There's nothing wrong with that. But once again, can this woman multiply, or can she add or multiply And she can she bring anything to the table that's gonna multiply your vision? Can she multiply? Can she time something? If you think of something, can she multiply? Can she bring something to it? You want a female to bring something to your ideas. Can she possibly figure out some loopholes or something? I mean, so many different ways. There's so many. I'm trying to say a lot, but I'm just trying to simplify it. Can that female add to your dreams? Can she multiply anything towards your dreams? Or is she going to subtract and divide? You gentlemen don't need that anymore. Oh, the Bergen bags, and take me this and take me there. And take, like, gentlemen, we've done all that. I've done all that. Take me here and entertain me and do this and do that. And we did all that. But now I just, you know, hey, listen. I got an idea. Boom. Let's push this product. And let's push this and let's push that. And hey, maybe we can get some land and do this, and we can build a studio or something crazy like that. You know, can if I shoot this to her, can she say, okay, babe, yeah, cool. You know, hey, if I spit it to her and she come back to me, hey, babe, listen, you was talking about that studio and the land. Okay, I seen a property over here for boom, 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 and it costs so a month. You know, and plus I know this guy, he does construction. You know, I think we can make that happen. Or we got to save some money, or, you know, get a loan, or, you know, I can, you know, we can get a business loan. I mean, gentlemen, that's the type of female that I'm looking for. Someone that's going to help me build for the sake of course, my children and other people's children, you know, so kids can have platforms. Because I'm not coming to the community and rebuilding. I'm going to where I'm going to, and I can build out there. And if the babies want to come to where I'm at, then I can help your child where I'm at. I'm not coming to where you are. Because where you are solidified, y'all been in that place of mediocrity for decades, maybe even centuries. I'm not coming to anybody's city and rebuilding anything. I'm going out here to some suburb or some country somewhere, and I can build out there. If y'all want to bang with me, this is where I'm going to be at. You know, it's like the field of dreams. If you build it, if I build it, you going to come. But anyways, gentlemen, getting back to the top. I know I went on a little diatribe, what I'm looking for. But yeah, gentlemen, stop listening to these manosphere people, manosphere dudes. And gentlemen, stick with the SYSBN philosophy. You gentlemen need to save yourselves. You need to go elsewhere and build, because there's a lot of women that desire you. There's a lot of women that want to breed with you. There's a lot of women that want your seed. There's a lot of women that are willing to help you. But you gentlemen have to separate yourself. You can't be in the darkness over here with these people that are going to spin in circles, but you expect something to change. It's not going to work like that. You gentlemen have to separate yourself and put yourself out there. Start doing stuff different. If there's different conventions with different other groups of people, go to these conventions. You know, hey, there's a convention for this group of people or this group of people. See what's it about. And that's how people get interested in you, because now you're sitting at a convention like, okay, well, yeah, we never seen a brother at one of our conventions. You'll be surprised at how many people will open themselves up to you and try to help you and do this. And a lot of women are interested in you because now you're stepping outside of your comfort zone. But anyways, gentlemen, that's all I got to say, man. I know I'm kind of off, but yeah, gentlemen. Stop with all this manosphere stuff. Stop with the manosphere. Once again, it was cool for all them years, 10 years ago, 8 years ago. But gentlemen, I mean, it's right now the manosphere is speaking in circles. And gentlemen, we can't have a circular conversation. The conversation is now is where do we need to move to and what needs to happen, like ASAP. You don't need to keep talking about, oh, do we owe the black community? And brother, why are you leaving? Why are you leaving them kids behind and all that stuff? You know, listen to these different panels. I mean, it's getting silly out here, gentlemen. It's getting silly out here. But anyways, man, that's all I got to say, man. You guys like, share, and subscribe. Peace.